check. Testing. 1, 2.
1, 2. This is the Mr. Nobody podcast.
Analyzing balance. Analyzing balance.
Stand clear.
This is the Mr. Nobody podcast.
No shock advised.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Episode 52. This concludes season one of the Mr. Nobody podcasts.
Check for pulse.
Okay, I shall check for pulse. I have a pulse. No, wait. Yeah. Yeah, I have a pulse. So I began this odyssey 1 year ago.
Analyzing now. Stand clear.
Not knowing what I would find or find out. In some way, not caring about that. Or shall I say, unconcerned.
Unconcerned.
If you're always going to steer where you know where you're going, what's the fun? There's no fun in that.
No shock advised.
Maybe that's the same impulse that makes us so interested in drugs. How's that for a pivot? We're so interested in drugs because they take us somewhere we don't know we're driving.
Or so we believe.
I mean, in some way, that is absolutely true. You don't know.
Check for pulse.
What kind of fucked up thing is going to happen? You just know some kind of fucked up thing is going to happen.
Is going to happen.
I think it's everybody's first experience with total surrender.
Like the first time you got drunk or super high.
Or perhaps you've been caught in the white water rushes of a river.
And you...
Let go.
Let go.
And you let that rushing water just take you. It's like drunken kung fu.
No pulse. Start CPR.
There's a relinquishing of control. You relax.
You spin with the car.
And see where you end up. In this episode.
The finale of season one.
I'd like to explore, or perhaps it's better stated as allow myself to be explored by this very terrible reality that 82,000 persons, former persons, according to this article, killed themselves last year.
Shock advised.
By lethal injection. By using various drugs. And the distinction they were making in the article is that it is not just opioids that is our crisis. It is a broader crisis. Stand clear.
Push to shock.
Say what?
That includes meth, whatever else. Crack.
I don't know. Maybe crack didn't make the cut.
Maybe booze, too, is in there. Definitely in there. People that have destroyed
their brains.
Meth, heroin, fentanyl, cracked.
Those are verbs.
And drunk themselves to death. That number, 82,000, surpasses...
Analyzing now. Stand clear.
It surpasses the number of people that killed themselves the year that my son did it.
He died by lethal injection.
That year it was 72,000. Not that it matters. I mean, every person should matter.
Analyzing balance.
That's very Kantian. That persons are special and they should never be used. Like, you should never use a group of people.
Shock advised.
To harvest their bones, for example, to build yourself a deck. That would be immoral, because you would be using people as a means to an end, or using them as drug customers.
Stand clear. Push to shock.
Analyzing balance.
Push, analyze.
That's immoral, because you're using people as a means to an end. And people are supposed to be special persons. Persons treated as an end in and of themselves.
No shock advised.
And not a means.
Check for pulse.
I think there's a case to be made that drug abusers are using themselves as a means to an end in an immoral context. Using their bodies to get high.
Riding.
Push, analyze.
Their horses.
They're riding their person-nedge like a horsey right into the gully of rocks to get high.
Check for pulse.
Dashing themselves against the stones. Lame.
Flame.
And obviously it's a big problem. Not just a problem, it's big business.
Stand clear.
It's big business, your addiction. Because 82,000 people must also be just it's big business, small sample of how many people are actually future customers dancing that stupid fucking dance. Your addiction is someone else's big business.
Analyzing now.
Big business.
Wait, analyzing now? You're a means, kind of late to an end, to analyze now, because you're dead. And you treat yourself that way. And the being dead part is easy. A welcomed end.
Yeah.
To the nonsense that accompanies
dirt napping,
rampant hard drug use.
Just a long sleep.
No more shitting your pants or freezing or having your family
hate you,
not be able to deal with you.
Heartbroken.
You're just gone.
You're not heartbroken.
And you might not even know you're gone. You used up your person.
As a means.
And they no longer...
To an end.
I don't know. Function.
Feng shui.
Here we go.
Sounds like cop show music.
Do it.
That's immoral.
Immoral.
Against the self.
Immoral.
Isn't it funny how we hate that word, morality? We think it's religious.
We may as well just touch on one other aspect of Immanuel Kant, for fuck's sake.
It's not religious.
Which is...
Stand clear.
His first formulation...
Of his
categorical imperative. Sounds complicated, but it's not.
And I'll just paraphrase it.
It's immediately...
grass bubble.
It is essentially this.
Like drinking water.
That no action is moral unless you would will it to be universal.
Explain.
In other words, you can't excuse your drug use, or any of your choices for that matter, just because you're doing it. And how would you know it's wrong? By what method?
No one is any kind of
exceptional person that gets to be wrong. And the way you do it,
what method?
Is you just try on, like a jacket, the idea of
just ask yourself,
willing everybody.
Would you want everybody
in the whole world,
everywhere,
to use drugs the same way you're using them?
Or do any of those other actions?
Or any action?
You want them to be?
It could be.
Universal?
I don't know. Fucking goats?
It could be.
Or.
You could be fucking goats.
Driving backwards.
Let's say recklessly.
Driving backwards because you feel like it.
Recklessly driving.
Being an asshole.
You just have to analyze whether or not any particular action, just fill in the X.
You kind of know, don't you?
And say, what I want everybody else.
You just feel it. We all.
To behave that way. To be a thief.
Feel it.
Or a murderer. Or a drug dealer.
Nobody wants everyone to be a murderer. No murderer wants that.
They might get murdered.
It just takes a little bit of common sense.
And respect for persons.
Clearly. Clearly, you would derive a morality that you would, wish upon the world, more potent than the golden rule, because it extends to other people. It's not just about you. And it wouldn't include
82,000
dead people.
Persons.
Dead persons.
Check for pulse.
Used.
By their drug habit.
Standby.
By their drug dealer. Really by yourself.
Yes, yourself.
Ridden.
Who are you going to blame?
Like a wild animal.
Who's in charge of you?
Who's driving? Drive.
By the way,
Immanuel Kant's third
formulation is that we somehow are able to detect the truth
for ourselves.
In this article, it was expressing how, prevalent drug use is right now because of the plague.
COVID-19.
And that somehow gave an excuse.
It felt like giving an excuse for
self-destruction, right? Because we're in a
self-destruction
rough spot.
As if.
And people are.
Self-destruction.
They're in a rough spot.
It's going to help.
But if you're a drug user, it's no rougher than it was
before.
Before.
It's the same. If you're an addict, you were a zombie then. You're a zombie now.
You're just as much a slave to your addiction now
as you were then. The game is the same.
It's totally the same.
You hustle money.
In fact, it might have been easier.
You call your drug dealer.
To get the drugs.
You buy your poison.
To make the money.
You play doctor.
I'm sure your drug dealer.
You inject it into your.
It's making it very easy.
Sad body.
For you to hook up right now.
And then you make.
Because they have to make money.
3 dozen excuses about.
By using you as a means.
Why you hate yourself, or why it's okay, or why you whatever.
To their immoral end.
You and I both know.
And you're contributing to that.
That's just bullshit. Lying to yourself.
Yeah.
Dying to yourself. Analyzing now.
Dying by lethal injection.
Immorally using your life.
Self-administered.
Because not only are you treating your personhood like just a piece of meat.
And the drug dealer.
With a fucking clock in it.
Is treating you like a valued customer.
Like a friend.
Because they need you.
but you're doing something that you would not...
More than you need them.
In your right mind.
Because you don't actually... You don't actually need the shit.
Want the whole world to be doing.
They just got you addicted.
Well, you got you addicted.
Zombieland.
They helped. How many times do we hear somebody say, I wouldn't wish this on my worst enemy?
I hate that fucking phrase.
It's easy. It's bullshit.
It's so ridiculous because...
Check for pulse.
You are your worst enemy.
You are
your enemy.
And you indeed have wished it upon yourself.
Your worst.
Upon your personhood.
Your worst enemy.
Treating yourself like a means to an end.
Using yourself.
82,000. That's the dead number.
It's shameful.
It's got to be 10 times, 20 times that.
We should all feel that shame.
With the people lining up.
It's not right.
To fall into the hole.
It's immoral.
What's getting us there?
What method?
In what way is drug use...
No shock advised.
...going to make anything better?
I never thought of it that way. I just can't stand the pain.
That sort of blows my mind. How's it going to help?
Guns blow my mind.
How is medicating yourself going to pay your rent?
It's not.
It's just saying fuck it.
It's saying fuck you.
And falling down the shaft.
Spinning. Out of control.
While screaming, fuck you.
To the whole world.
To the whole world.
To yourself.
It's a means to an end.
1 year I've been ranting and raving.
Ranting and raving.
And trust me, I've been mad.
A madman.
I'm mad at my son.
I don't want to be, but it's useless to pretend.
I talk to him
that I'm not.
You know, like a crazy person.
Cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Saying, you're a fucking asshole.
If no pulse, start CPR.
What the fuck were you doing this shit for?
You sold out. You sold out your life.
And whatever answer comes.
My daughter tells me I'm stuck.
It really doesn't matter.
That is true.
There's no good answer.
There's no reversing.
I'm so mad at him.
I bought my son a computer.
You just spin in the car.
I bought it used, and I got a great deal on it because I'm that kind of guy. In fact, my computer is used.
You're out of control.
I'm thrifty.
How could you buy into this shit? This drug bullshit.
And it's upstairs.
Letting go.
Shock advised.
It's under my desk.
Shock advised.
And I'm afraid to open it.
I really am.
And sort through.
I'm so fucking mad at you, son.
His life.
His life. What was his life?
His life.
Because nothing I'm going to encounter in there is going to yield a different outcome.
Yield a different outcome.
His life.
Your life.
This is such bullshit. 87.
82,000.
Oh, sorry, 82,000.
And now we're making huge excuses that COVID somehow has made your life so hard that you've decided to pick up
sellout
and narco-medicate yourself
and be used
by cartels and your friendly neighborhood drug dealers.
Analyzing now. Stand clear.
Sure, you're a victim too. American companies have been making billions of dollars supplying the chemicals that killed you.
Death by lethal injection.
Acetic anhydride, the chemical needed to make meth,
and you,
fentanyl,
are gobbling it
and heroin
down.
Greedily.
Gobbling down. Shooting into your veins, sucking into your lungs
to kill yourself,
using yourself
as a means to an end.
It's immoral.
Think the death penalty is immoral?
And that doesn't require belief in supernatural beings.
What about killing yourself?
Shock advised.
By?
It just requires you.
Lethal?
To think it out.
Injection.
Treating yourself like a piece of meat with a clock stuffed in it.
It's bullshit.
I'm so mad at my son.
It's grieving.
I had dinner with my daughter,
my beautiful daughter,
and her lovely partner.
Who was missing?
Who's missing at this table?
My son.
And although nothing is assured in life, can't really
be a fucking baby.
Be a baby about the unexpected.
No shock advised.
This is different. This is killing yourself.
Categorically.
This is elective.
Don't spin it.
It's not like you got COVID.
This is not some sickness like cancer
and started shutting down.
Or diabetes. Something you were born with.
You gave yourself an addiction.
Addiction is the disease.
And now you're out of control.
We give ourselves.
And you're gonna die
as a means to an end.
And you're gonna destroy.
Check for pulse.
You're gonna destroy people like me. One year, I've been asking myself, am I any better? Have I worked anything out?
I don't know if you have.
This purgation through music, sound design, grumbling,
complaining,
guitar, I mean, who fucking cares?
I know what you mean. It doesn't matter. Because he's so dead. He didn't get wings. He's not an angel in heaven. Don't drink the Kool-Aid.
It does not replace.
But do eat.
Or soften.
The dog food.
The insult.
Of truth.
Was it that good?
How?
My beautiful son?
How will you know what is true, son? What method?
To lay yourself down.
Can you ask yourself?
Put your headphones on.
That I would want this for everybody.
Shoot up.
That this would become a universal maxim.
And die?
That using drugs and doing the things that are associated.
I hope it was worth it.
Being high.
Because you lost everything.
82,000 dead by lethal injection.
It's not just what you're feeling.
We're not islands.
It's not all about you, my beautiful son.
Conflating.
That high.
The first.
That low.
And the second.
That numbness.
Kantian formulation.
Is fed by murder.
Into one.
Rape.
Egregious.
Crime of sorts that.
Immoral.
You can't imagine.
Reality.
But you're supporting.
You're supporting those criminals.
You're giving those things lifeblood.
That they're stealing your life.
You're using them.
From you.
Just as much as they're using you.
For fucking profit.
You
it worth it? Selling yourself out for heroin, fentanyl, methamphetamines? Is the high that fucking good? If you're shaking your head yes,
then at least be willing to vomit. To vomit your fucking life of your life.
Analyzing balance.
It's fucking shameful. I'm saying this to you because I want you to live.
I wanted you to live.
And maybe not die by throwing your life away like my son did.
Keep no pulse. Start CPR.
But it's over. It's over for me. I've said that a few times in these podcasts.
What would you say to your son?
If you're this fucking stupid.
Or daughter.
Where you would use drugs when you know. Whoa.
You so totally fucking know.
You know where this is going.
What would you say to your own child? To your parent?
Are you that much of a zombie?
Would you say it's okay?
That much of a wraith?
If that's what helps you get through COVID?
A shadow?
Go ahead. Shoot up. Smoke meth. Make excuses about.
Shock advised.
I don't know why you're special.
Yes, shock advised.
Shock advised.
How dare you?
It's a crime.
How dare you be
against the self?
A fucking user.
Using yourself as a means to the worst end.
I wouldn't have let him.
Would you will it?
And not just an end.
Would you demand that everyone in the world
but a through line
be this way too?
Till the end comes.
No, it's just for you. Private little masturbation.
Jerk off.
We're definitely getting played. We're getting preyed upon and played. I don't think we can help junkies anymore. Meth heads, crackheads.
Once you're in, you're in.
Help yourself. Good luck.
Analyzing now. Stand clear.
I think you're fucked.
Sadly.
This many people dead. Next year will be more.
Sadly.
It's so obvious that it just seems like it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that it's obvious.
It's like part of the culture, like...
The rehabs are never going to clean you up. It's a game.
Coca-Cola.
It's a jive-ass...
McDonald's.
Sick...
Starbucks.
Immoral game.
Heroin.
One you shall lose.
One that shouldn't be played for the reasons it's being played.
And others will lose with you.
That's why.
It's selfish.
Shock advised.
It's disgusting.
Nobody likes those words, selfish and disgusting, do they?
It is beneath your personhood.
But truth. We love that word.
And the vampires that are getting fat on your blood.
The cartels, the drug dealers.
I personally don't think they deserve it. Yeah, I don't think they deserve your financial support. But that's who you're helping.
Check for pulse.
And they're using you, riding you like an animal.
They are terrorists and should be treated as such.
And they're gonna jump off of you before you hit
those lithics,
those sharpened stones.
No shock advised.
You're gonna check for pulse. There's gonna be no pulse.
What did you think would happen, son?
Because I know you thought. 1 year of this. You always thought about things.
Kill your local heroin dealer. Bomb the cartels.
I am no closer to my son.
Check for pulse.
didn't think about what you would do.
I can't forgive him.
To your beautiful.
It's an unforgivable thing.
Your beautiful life, your body, your mind.
To destroy yourself.
Yourself.
Your vehicle.
Mr. Nobody.
Season 1, finale.